Hi everyone and welcome back to the channel. And in today's video, I'm going to explain you how to use Voiceflow extensions, which is like a super cool way to make your chatbots look just fabulously amazing. And literally, let me just quickly show you how they look. So for example, you can see here are three options that I have created as extensions in Voiceflow, which you can utilize to change the way your chatbot looks. So let's start with our favorite ones. Every time that someone comes to a chatbot, you want to get their details, right? So this is the way that you can create a beautiful form and get their inputs on. So let's say we put in Akshat, right? And then email at a@a.com and double it. I want to show you one more cool stuff here. Okay, let me say I just remove this and try to click submit. You can see it will make sure that there is a validation that needs to be present to input this data, right? And this is super cool because the point is you want to get the right data when someone is entering into a chatbot. And as soon as you say submit, you can see the name also displays here and this data is actually coming from the chatbot. That is why Voiceflow. So the point is, like, once you build an extension, you can actually send out data back to Voiceflow, get that data back from it, and literally just use it in every way possible. Let me show you another example. It's ratings, right? So again, I can rate my experience whenever you are trying to look for feedback, when you want to try a product, like, you know, you are trying to recommend a product and you can get their inputs on, and then you can also store this data as you request, right? Again, so this is just a great way to request it and, like, utilize this data. You can also use it to upload a file. Okay, so let's come back to Voiceflow and see what's happening here. So let me just zoom out quickly and show you what's happening here. I have three buttons, which you were very easily able to see when we were trying to utilize this, right? So you could see three buttons, which are simple: form, rating, and upload a file. If you don't know where to get buttons from, just go to listen and select buttons. Now, once you have the buttons, what I've done is I've inputted that to be selected to this crazy looking feature here, and it's called a custom action. So if you want to get something like this, what I'm going to do is select dev, go here and bring out custom action. This is step number one to define what kind of extension you want to create, right? Now again, very simply, what we have to do is just write the name of the extension. Now I already have an extension called aesthetic form, so I'm going to create a new extension which we are going to show together and how it works, and I'm just going to write ext form. Okay, now once I've done that, I have to create a path name. So path names are nothing, it is the output that you have to get after submitting a form. For example, in case someone submits the form and you don't get the data, you will write to have a path which is like correct, which is the path for, like, if everything goes well, and then a path for error. Okay, I hope this is simple enough. You're just dropping a custom action from here and writing the name of what kind of an extension name you want to have and just use this. Again, you don't need to write extension form. You can just write form also, or you can write, like, you know, India, or you can write US, whatever. So I'm just using ext form because, again, when you're developing these solutions, you want to be pretty right on the naming convention for future things. Now, here is an option that you see, stop on action. What does this mean? That means that whenever I am trying to use an extension, let's say I'm trying to input a form, you should not proceed until you get some data back from the form. So until you get data back from the form, don't do anything. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to click this. So that means it will stop until I submit a form. Okay, perfect. Now, once you are done with this, I'm just going to do is I'm going to disconnect this part, right? And again, pretty simple enough. You're just going to remove this thing and we're going to technically just remove this, drag it away, and you're going to plug this thing here. And now I want to drag, and again, very simply drag and connect to this block. Now you have another option here, which is the JavaScript part, right? And again, it is a very simple one. So I'm going to teach you this in just a minute. Okay, just hold on with me. Now, extension is defined, but we actually don't have anything. How will the form look? How is the form going to perform and everything else? So what we're going to do is, we're going to go back to our beautiful old ChatGPT. Okay, now what we are going to do is we need to define an extension. And let me show you an example to understand what we are trying to create. If you come here, this is what a form extension looks like. Now again, this is a JavaScript code. Again, you don't have to worry about this. We are going to show you how to do this very quickly and very easily. But this is what the JavaScript code looks like, right? It has everything, details about the form, what we are trying to create, and again, the style of it and the HTML of it and everything else. But you don't have to worry. But what I wanted to show you is to input a form as an extension or any kind of extension, you need to create a JavaScript code. So what I have done for you guys is I already have this massive prompt already created. I think this is what, like, yeah, this is 6500 characters, so like, yeah, around 400-500 words with code and everything. What we're going to do is we just need to copy this prompt, and this will be available in the link below. And just paste this in ChatGPT. That's it. You're just going to wait there. And it's going to ask us what kind of an extension we want to create. Okay. So again, very simply, I just want to create a form extension. So I'm going to write that. I want to create an extension asking for name and their favorite superhero in dark style. Okay. Now that's what I've given as a basic input. Right now, it's going to create all the code that is required. Okay. Now, if you see, it's not only creating the format of, like, you know, how things will look like, but also how every part of the extension is looking like, the color coding and everything. So we're just going to pause the video and show you the final code because I don't want to bore you guys. Okay, so the extension is ready, right? Again, I just had to write one more thing, is like ensure all the style and CSS is written within the function. So again, I just get a simple function that I don't need to copy and paste a lot of times. Now, on the right-hand side, if you can see, I've just shown you how your normal Voiceflow script looks like. So you know, you get a JavaScript integration option, right? And how to integrate that and get something like a script. Now again, if you see, there are a couple of things that we have added here. You can obviously remove them if required, as a username, render, and like an auto start, allow dangerous HTML, and etc. And then also, is the main thing that we add is in assistant, under assistant, we do these curly braces and add this extensions part. Now, you can see this is a demo code. So the name of the extension seems to be form extension. But if you see on the left-hand side, the name that is given to ChatGPT is like dark form extension. Again, you can change it if required, but very simply, this is what the name looks like. So let me just do this. You want to copy this code from this constant, or like, you know, constant dark form extension, and just drag it down till this particular part where you see this code piece ending, right? Again, you can technically copy and paste this and also run, right? So if you want to do that, I can show you how to, like, just you can do as copy this, right? And we can technically paste this whole thing here. And you have everything in a single place. All the extensions, everything that is required is already present. You can just copy and paste the code if you're asking it for a single extension. The only thing you will have to add if you're trying to do that is an example ID here, okay? So I'm not going to show you my example ID. I'm just going to put an ID and show you the final output, but let me explain you how this works. Okay, this is pretty simple. The name is dark form extension. There's an extension dark form. Now, if you see, this is trace.type. This means it will be looking for an input of something like this name, extension dark form. So if you want to use the same form name, you have to go back to Voiceflow and change this name from ext form to ext dark form, or you have to change this name to ext form. Okay. So right now I'm just going to keep this dark form and leave it there. Okay. Now after that, it has just defined all the CSS classes. It has defined, like, you know, how the form looks. Again, nothing for you to worry about. Literally nothing. You can just copy and paste and run this. Okay. This, I'm not going to, like, explain you HTML and CSS here, but very simply, you can just copy and paste this. Now, after that, what we see here is very simple. Our Voiceflow script, again, with the details and the name extensions. Now, if you ever want to add more extensions, you will just do a comma and add rating extension or whatever the name is. Okay. Pretty simple, straightforward way to utilize it. Now, one feature that I really need to show you is, you see this window.voiceflow.chat.interact. This is part of the function. ChatGPT has already created this for us. Very simply, you see a type complete, and in that payload option, you have name, comma, superhero. Now, what is a payload? Payload, in simple terms, is just the data that the form is going to send back to Voiceflow. So in simple terms, you will be able to extract this data in Voiceflow using JavaScript, okay? Now, just let me, like, myself, right? As soon as I click on this JavaScript option here, right? If you see extension dark form and click on JavaScript, I already have a variable named name, and is equal to last event.payload.name. Again, so whatever this last event.payload, this line is going to stay the same. Only thing that you need to change is select the variable that is there. So very simply, if I have to write superhero, so I'm just going to write superhero is equal to last event.payload.superhero. Because that's what the variable is coming here. If you want to change it to, I don't know, like, you know, India, you can change that. And, like, and I don't know why I keep saying India, but, like, very simply, you can change it to any word that you want. And you can see it's already getting data from here, right? So again, if you're changing this here, that means you need to change here also. So if you change, like, it to, like, you know, just let's say from superhero, you want to make it Batman, right? So we change this to Batman, and then we need to change this also to Batman, okay? This is it, okay? And simply you can see other variables will also be there where they would have a reference superheroes. So wherever superheroes is written, you have to go ahead and change it to Batman. It's just a variable, okay? So you don't have to worry if you're just using the standard technical thing that's created by ChatGPT. We can just let it be, okay? So I'm just going to let it be. Now what we're going to do is, technically nothing, we're just going to click publish, because I've just changed the name and I want to see how this runs, right? And I also want to do one thing, okay? So you see this data that is coming. I already have this connected here where I can utilize this. So this form of works, and I will probably change this to YouTube demo by, and then the name variable is something that you can output. So that means everything that is input into the form is can be extracted using JavaScript. You can store that into your variable. So this variable like name or superhero. So if I want to create a new variable superhero, let me just do that. Okay. So let me go ahead and like write superhero. Again, I'm sure you guys know how to create a variable, right? So very simply create this, click on create variable, right? And then again, I can just simply say your, what is happening? Your favorite superhero. That's it. I'm just going to leave it at that. And everything that we're getting for these variables is getting in this JavaScript. Very simple, last event.payload.superhero. Okay, simple enough. Now what we're going to do is just go to the next step. We are going to publish this because I want to make sure that the extension doc form and everything is there. And I'm going to update this code to have my project ID here. Okay, so this is the moment of truth. I have everything here on my page and I'm just going to like zoom in a bit so you guys can see it better. Right, and let me just move myself to like this. And you can see it's a pretty blank page. I've not done anything HTML on the page. So I'm just going to click form. And technically, we should get a form. Oh, this looks pretty cool. I want to probably zoom out and see how this looks. Right, I think it's like a super cool form. Again, you can ask it to make the CSS better and everything else, but I'm just going to keep it here. I'm going to enter my name, Akshat, and I'm going to enter my superhero as Iron Man. Sorry, Batman fans or Marvel DC fans or anything. And just click submit. And it should hopefully work. I don't think it's working. Okay, so very stupid issue. I just went to ChatGPT and said, like, you know, just see why it's not working. It just did something and then that's it pretty much. I'm not going to bore you with it. Just select form and hopefully it should work. And we'll just say, Akshat Bahety, and then I'm going to write Iron Man. Just look at the quality of the, like, you know, the form that has come out, right? And this message is coming from HTML. So thanks, Akshat Bahety. We see that your favorite superhero is Iron Man. And this is coming from Voiceflow. So let me show this to you, right? So very specifically, if you see here, right? If you see here, it's writing this final line. Yes, form container.innerHTML. And you can see, thanks, Akshat Bahety. We see that your favorite is superhero is XYZ. You can obviously remove this if you want, but very simply, it exists for your own benefit, right? So again, very simply, it works and you can use it in multiple options, right? You can, if I click on rating, it will not show up anything because the problem is like, you know, again, there is no rating extension created here, right? I wanted to show you is an upload a file, right? I just missed that while I was saying. So you can select this to choose a file and upload, right? So I'm just going to like take a test and then upload it, right? Now this will work completely fine. And you can also see like, you know, here is the link to your file and everything. So you can go ahead and see if you're watching this, please like, share and subscribe. And guys, please do. It really helps me out a lot, right? It takes time to create all these videos. But the point is, one thing that I want to tell you while you're uploading a file, that if you see this is running on a server, right? For all other extensions, you don't need this. But for uploading a file, because there needs to be an API request made, you need to use a server for this, right? So again, just like remember that. And again, when you are trying to like build a solution, just make sure that you keep that in mind. But other than that, this is like a super cool way to increase the value of your products and really do some amazing work. But my point is that you can use these extensions to really increase the value of your Voiceflow agents just by the way that they look, and also like, you know, match the brand guidelines so much more. Like for example, instead of just showing carousels, you can also like, you know, create something interactive here, create a different kind of an extension, maybe like a small mini game for someone to wait for a response from an API. Again, the world is your oyster, right? And again, I'm just thinking that you can just increase your value so much more by utilizing this. Okay, so go ahead, test it out. Again, I'll have the code for all the extensions, which is the rating part, the file upload part, and everything else there. And if you want all the details, they are in description. Go ahead and check them out. And please hit the like, share, and subscribe button. I would love to see you in the next one.